Hello, I'm Allegra McEvedy, and for today's World Gastronomic Delight, we travelled to Burma, where I had some fantastic leafy green fritters with a kind of chili tamarind dip, and then came back here and recreated it, and it goes a little bit like this. So first thing you do is make the batter, which is a weighed game. 75 grams of gram flour, 200 grams of plain yoghurt. You can use Greek, but then you'll need a bit more water to let it down, because it's thicker. Half a teaspoon of turmeric, half a teaspoon of ground coriander, a bit of salt. Just get in there with your whisk, bring it all together. Clearly that's a bit thick for a batter, so you just let it down with a little bit of warm water. Batter done. Very easy, this recipe. So next up we're going to make the dipping sauce, which is sort of the poke and the fun of the whole thing. And it's based around tamarind, which is, well, that's what it looks like. It's a sort of fruit pod, and they use a lot of it over in that part of the world. It brings a sort of rich, delicious fruitiness. And into that we're going to put some chilli. Obviously you can put as much chilli as you want. I quite like a bit of heat. This dish is basically a cousin of the onion bhaji, but to me it tastes much fresher and more interesting, less greasy too. Chop your shallot as finely as you can. This is a banana shallot, but obviously you can use a regular little round one as well. It took me years to work out, they're just a bit more work. A little shot of fish sauce, some lime juice. Chop curry. Stalks and all for the coriander. Hiya! Whew. That's really exciting. Now I want to keep these kind of chunky for this because I think it's nice to have the greeny bits. So quite wide ribbons, and you can use all the stalk as well. And then what we want to do is pop them into our batter, which is basically just a binding agent. Yeah, you can use anything, any other greens than bok choy really. I mean, you could use Chinese cabbage or pak choy or even tender stem broccoli or something like that. You just want something that's sort of got an appropriately Asian influence. So I'm just gonna put in some very basic frying oil here. So the first thing you've gotta do is check that your oil is up to temperature. So just drop a piece in. And what you want to do is to fizzle and float. Fizzle and float, perfect. And then you know they're ready to go. I like them so they're all angular, so there's lots of pieces sticking out. So you're not frying the individual pieces of bok choy, but little clumps of them. So that's literally how you do it. I mean, I love that kind of mad, irregular shapes. It makes a great little starter, or canapé. I've done it as both in my time. And yeah, just a more fun, it's a better bhaji.